again, under the framework of the Caribbean Basin Security Initiative, the provision of the two interceptor vessels, the vehicle can move it around, plus this communications equipment that will allow for enhanced communication with the vessels, with landings and the coasts in the air. You know, those agreements are in place. They're operating very well. In fact, I mean, I was here at the time they were negotiated, and what I've been intrigued to see is, I think some countries would like to see us use that much more. We have had regularly, whenever a Coast Guard vessel is in the region, we try to get a ship rider from Dominica, St. Vincent, St. Lucia, other countries, you know, Barbados when possible as well, on board so that they can exercise that law enforcement authority. That was the purpose of those agreements. So those agreements are working wonderfully. We again wish we had more vessels in the region that we could exercise them more regularly. But with what we have, we're doing the best we can and partnering very well with that. But we will sign one of these memorandum with each of the Eastern Caribbean countries to provide these vessels, and we'll also be working with the RSS in that regard as well.
We'll be in Antigua, Barbuda this year, and along with that, we've had the opportunity to make some regional investment in Antigua of a little over $200,000 in engineering-related construction that will benefit the Antiguan Defense Force, and we will be enhancing a training area for urban training that they did not have before, improving a few roads there for training, as well as a range facility. And that will also help facilitate the over 580 Caribbean personnel that will be training with us for those 2 weeks, as well as the over 480 United States forces that will be here in a training capacity. Those are not all the military forces. It is interagency effort. We will be collaborating with your law enforcement agencies. We have the Federal Bureau of Investigation and the Naval Criminal Investigative Service coming down to share their techniques and what they've learned from everything from crime scene investigation to gang-related history and activity of what we know and how to combat those types of threats to our sovereign nations as we gather here for that type of training.
I think that's exactly right. I saw the presentation that Security Coordinator made with his 4 points, one of which was to enhance the regional training center, and that's certainly something we have discussed. And I mean, our focus through CBSI and with all of this is to build capacity in the region. So this would be a natural venue for us to work with the RSS and other countries around the region to strengthen training. Clearly, that's part of all that we do, all of the visits of our vessels, the SWIFT and other things. So that's very much something that would fit naturally with what we're doing. Just one other little point, I got the word that there have been 6 bilateral ship riders since September last year to the present time in the region. So we have been exercising those ship rider agreements. And with that.